The House of Dread Radio Sound System.
Greetings, Barcelona! Here we are once again, you know. First contact was actually my dad. My dad used to play a motor organ.
Yeah.
You know? So, and he's like, you know, it sounds good. So I asked him to get one for me at the market. So he got me one, you know, play with that some. You know, and then they used to sing sometime, you know, and Saturdays, because they became Adventists after a while. So my dad and my stepmom, you know, on Friday evening and Saturdays, they would sing songs, you know what I mean? And my dad would like sing the baritone, you know, sweet, you know. But then, you know, after I started to go to church with them, there was the choir. And also there were these seven sisters that used to sing together. Most beautiful, you know. Not my sisters, but you know, they were sisters. You know, like blood sisters, right. And they would sing together, sometime a duet, sometime a trio, quartet, quintet, you know what I mean? But it's beautiful. And then I moved to Kingston.
We with equal rights and justice. It's nowhere to be found. It's nowhere to be found. If you got it in your bosom,
But before even that, when at the age of about 9, I went to Kingston on a school trip.
A school trip to
the stadium. You know, all the little school in the country would meet at the stadium for a big function. And the Scatterlights were playing.
Yeah.
Right, you know, I saw them for the first time and I was like, oh, that's what I want to do, you know what I mean? So, you know, so I got more interested. And when I moved to Spartan, then I moved to Kingston. When I moved to Kingston when I was between 15 and 16, put together a little group called the Brothers. In the process of that time, I met Errol Grandison, formerly member of the Gladiators. And at the time, they lost a member. So he asked me basically we sung a few songs together, you know, and he asked me if I would be perfect for the slot, you know. So he went and checked Albert Griffiths, you know, until Albert Griffiths. And a few days later, we met, you know, and there went it, you know, from then on for 18 years.
18 years.
Stand up.
In 1987,
I did the last tour with Gladiator. We finished the tour in Florida,
yeah.
And we had excess time on our visa.
Yes.
So we call a friend up in the Seattle area and say, hey, well, we have excess time on the visa. I would like to do something before going back to Jamaica. So we went there, you know, except Albert didn't went, the rest of us did. We were there for like 7 weeks or something yeah. like that, you know. We were there for like about between six to seven months, you know, and, you know, develop a good following. Making money, more money than we make when we tour with Gladiators, you know what I mean? Yeah. We figure, hey man, we can come back each time and, you know, make some money, you know? So we went back to Jamaica and the drummer died. And so we paused for a while. We came back to Seattle, went back to Seattle. We found a drummer there.
Yeah.
We're still going. The Fenders and then Boogie Brown Band. The Fenders went on for like about five years,
yeah.
You know, and then I put together Boogie Brown Band. Boogie Brown Band been going now for close to 20 years, or 18 years. I don't do anything else other than music. That's how I survive.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's what I love what I do, and so I do what I love, you know?
Yeah. That's the best.
Yeah, yeah, and that's what I always try to tell to big people, young kids, you know, age group like yourself. Don't be afraid to go for what you really love, because then, you know, you feel yourself, you know what I mean? And it makes you feel good.
Yeah, living is an art, no?
take
care of creation. There's so much to gain.
The man.
message go?
The message, man, live your life with love, man. No matter what, live your life with love. Again, you know, love yourself. Don't be afraid to love yourself, you know. And if you love yourself, then of course you're gonna do what's best for you. You know what I mean? Again, do what you love. You know, it goes right back to that, you know. Yeah, you feel good, you know what I mean? And so that will enable you to love yourself, love your neighbor, love your surrounding, love Mother Nature, you know, because, you know, again, nature is so important. So important. Yeah, you know, we kind of push it aside, you know, for academic reasons and things like that. But, you know, nature, man, so intelligent. So intelligent. Yeah.
We are nothing.
Remember, Jah said, the homeland that me they shall be well.
Another project coming. I have another project, which another song that should be another album that should be released in next spring. Next spring, 2014, a band album. You know, Boogie Brown. Right. You know, I'm feeling good about that one. Yeah. Feeling really good about. I'm sure you will hear about it.
Sure.
It's a good one.
You know,
but in the summer of this year, in the summer, we're coming back with Clinton Ferran and Friends.
Yeah.
You know, because we came earlier, later in the year, in October, November,
yeah.
You know, and we did part of Europe, you know, doing art and soul, right. It was a good vibe,
We hope.
So we want to do, you know, a summer stretch of it.
Yeah.
And then after that, it will be Boogie Brown Band, you know.
Yeah.
So I've tried. Three different projects.
Every day more young. You are. Every day more young.
You know what? You know, people ask what same thing. I was gonna first into it. You know, I've got asked that several times. What's the secret? Again, man. I just love what I do, man.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And the other thing, because I spend, like I said, 18 of my young years. Gladiators, you know what I mean? Serving gladiators. You know, I think that it's time I do something for myself, you know what I mean? And with people who are with me on that, you know? So I'm kind of a late bloomer, you know? You know, and one other thing is, like, you know, I'm kind of somewhat a perfectionist, but not really. You know what I mean? Because I love when the thing is a little dirty still. You know what I mean? But I love when the root is there, you know, bite is there, you know, right. But and I always see myself at, you know, 10-15%, maybe, you know what I mean, wanting to reach 100. So no matter how much I do, I see more to do. I want to learn more. I want to get further. I want to, you know, be bigger with it, you know. I want to know it some more, basically know it some more, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'll put in some more, you know, and I'm not there yet, you know, I'm not there yet, but I'm learning.
Yeah.
Yes, oh yes, we got changes, a little bit of peace, that's what it took. Finally,
first guitar. I made my first guitar.
Yes, you make it yourself.
Make it myself. And I made my own tools because I was living in the hills with my dad. You know, after like nine, like right when I was nine, you know, my stepmom, they broke up. And me and my dad and I, we resort to the hills, you know what I mean? So we live in the woods. We live in the woods, you know. You know, we live in the woods. And so, you know, I wanted a guitar, you know, and I asked my dad, can you buy me a guitar, dad? But I don't have any money. I'm thinking, I have to get me a guitar. So I got a piece of cedar trunk, you know, and shake the guitar out of it with my masher, you know. Like, doing what we love and loving what we do. Yes. It with great pleasure. With great pleasure, I'm here once again, you know, to join together. We're doing this together. It's like a big living room, you know. Hey, this is Clinton Ferron.
Yeah.
You're listening to Radio Argentina. Illicit rebel movements in this place and in this town and everywhere. Anytime, every place. Much love.
Thank you. Big up.
Big up.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.